Hello all, today we'll take a look at the spider plant in our home. I have put a video of the spider plant a month ago where we were seeing different ways of propagation of this plant. It's easy to grow and easy to propagate. It's a very good plant for the beginners. It grows well, requires very less maintenance and easy to propagate as well. It withstands a variety of temperatures. It doesn't require direct sunlight, so it's good to keep in a shady place, and there is no need to water it too much also. A month ago I had put a video where you would have seen the runners of this plant. This is the same plant which we were seeing in my previous video. Spider plant grows runners through which we get new plants. A month ago, all these plantlets at the end of the runner were very small and roots were not there much. So I had left it like that for the roots to form. Now you can see that the new plant has grown well and it has rooted well automatically in the soil. We don't have to do anything like any other plant. It will find its own way to grow, survive and sustain. So you can see new leaves coming out of this plantlet. So it's growing well into a new plant on its own. You can see two separate plantlets were there and both were growing nicely. So what we can do is, I think it's time for us to cut this runner so that this plant can grow well and this can grow on its own now. Spider plant grows very fast, so it's good to keep in a bigger container. It also forms a lot of roots, tap roots as well as feeder roots, quickly. So there is no need for too much watering. It looks nice. It's good to keep outdoors as well as indoors. It looks nice when you keep it on hanging baskets because the leaves grow longer and cascades to the sides. It will look wonderful when kept in hanging baskets indoors. It also absorbs toxic chemicals, so it helps us when this plant is kept indoors. So what we will do is, we'll cut off the runner now and allow these plants to grow on its own. You can cut it anywhere, but we'll try to cut close to the edge. Make sure that you don't cut or hurt or harm the mother plant, so do it as gently as possible. So now this is growing well. This will grow nicely, and you can see already there is a new runner coming from the mother plant. So it keeps growing runners, and at the edge you can see small plantlets. You can cut this and plant separately, or like how I'm doing, you can allow the roots to form, then later you can put it in a pot. Next time I'll try to put indoors as well, try different methods and put in different kinds of pots so that it looks nice indoors. So this is about our spider plant. It looks beautiful It's beneficial, it's pleasing for the eyes, grows very fast and easy to maintain, easy to propagate as well. So this is our new spider plant growing nicely. Two plants we have, and this is the mother plant which is ready to give another new plant. Small plantlet as of now. I'll leave it for it to grow bigger and better and for the roots to form before I put it in a container separately. It's good to keep this spider plant in a pot which contains loose soil, because this forms a lot of roots. So if the soil is harder, it becomes difficult for the roots. So it's good to have loose soil so that it's easy to grow, as well as you mix it with sand. Also, try to put natural fertilizers, organic fertilizers. There is no need to put chemicals to harm the plant. It grows well, nice. We have another spider plant on the other side, a similar one. We'll have a look at that now. This is the one more spider plant which we have. This is also growing tall and well. You can see a plantlet from the runner of the mother plant. Roots are already being formed. So as usual, I'll leave it here in this pot so that it can grow and root deeper. Then we can cut off this runner. I'll try to keep spider plant indoors also. Maybe in another video we can see. I'll try to put a hanging basket kind. Hope you like this spider plant. Thank you for watching. See you in another video. Bye.